always, whether it is Ramadan or not Ramadan, when you are far from family, it's always difficult. But on the other side, I can say, as I'm here now in South Africa for about 10 years, and especially in Cape Town that I lived for those 10 years, I can say now I feel also home here. And the good thing about South Africa is the fundamentals of the environment that a Muslim person needs in order to live was already here in South Africa. The culture was here, it is not something new. If you say I'm a Muslim in South Africa, it's not something new. You find that everything was already here. So in that case, there is nothing like, you know, that I'm feeling like I say, okay, if I would be here in my country, then I would could do that thing that I cannot do here. No, there is nothing like that. Otherwise, missing the family is always something that exists. Ramadan is the time that one should look, should seek, you know, the coming closer to his creator, Allah, you know? So that is one of the important aspects of Ramadan. Second is also coming closer to the communities also and the families, you know, is also another aspect of Ramadan. There is no one single night that I had my breakfast alone. Also with my son and my brother, but with the family members, with friends, you know. It was always, you know, coming together and sharing together and enjoying, you know. So it also recreates, you know, the family connection again, you know, and a friendship connection, you know. A lot of things that a Muslim should do during the Ramadan, maybe he or she was doing before Ramadan, but increase, like the like worshiping, you know, like prayer. But in Ramadan you increase, like charity giving is also a way of worshiping Allah, you know. So some people might also say God, you know, in English. So that, for example, charity, that one should always give, you also increase. So it's a lot of good deeds that one should do. So I can say is in Ramadan, for a Muslim person, is a moral regeneration or otherwise transformation, you know, in which the possibility is that the lessons that you learn during Ramadan should also continue until the end of your life. And I would also mention that like, you know, things like gossiping and backbiting that normally might happen among the people, it's something that one should avoid during Ramadan, you know? And again, it's a good habit that one can continue.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
In Ramadan, one should seek the closeness to Allah, you know? So the more prayer you make, the more you are near to Allah. And and also, the more prayer you make, the more good person you become also. So it has a very high importance for the Muslim person.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويطعمون الطعام على حبه مسكينا ويتيما وأسيرا إنما نطعمكم لوجه الله لا نريد منكم جزاء ولا شكورا.
Giving charity to the underprivileged, I mean the poor part of the society, you know, so that one the person, the Muslim person who is fasting, should also be generous, you know, which might be also a good habit that he learners or adapts in that moment during Ramadan, and then he or she might continue until the end of his or her life. The end of Ramadan day, you know, Eid day, it's compulsory for the Muslim person to give fitrah, which is charity in English. You know, it's a compulsory. And that charity is not only that you as a father or mother should give. You should also give charity from the child of yours. The objective of the charity giving is that every family should be happy that day. In South Africa, for example, we have a cultural diverse society in South Africa, which is in somewhere is a good thing. So I would urge all religious leaders to use their own faith to empower the communities. And, you know, whether you are a Muslim community leader or Christian community leader or Jewish community leader or any other African or traditional leader, you should use your own faith and position to empower the community. I'm saying this because in every culture, charity giving is an important issue, you know. It's a very important issue. Neighborhood is a very important issue, you know. People sometimes when they see the goodness of this kind of particular culture, they just respect. They all respect, you know. And it all depends on what are the feedbacks of your actions, you know. You know, that's the important thing. You know, whatever you do, I emphasize, and as our religion orders us, you know, we should work towards a better life for the humanity in general.